Hi. Well, hello there. TikTok, happy Saturday night. Yes. So great to see you all here tonight. As promised, here I am in my kitchen. As promised, I'm gonna cook. Nothing crazy, nothing wild, nothing super out of control, but I was gonna do shrimp tacos, but all of my tortillas, they're so fresh and organic and they just busted apart, so I'm gonna do tostadas instead. Hi, how are you? Thank you for the rose. And I took that weird, bizarre filter off, so hopefully it doesn't do that. Yes, hi. Shoe check Saturday, 100%. It is true. Shoe check Saturday. Yes. The Manolo Blahniks tonight, guys, gals, everyone. Hey, how are you? Hi, Richard, how are you? Happy Saturday, guys. Hopefully I have my moderators on here. Jeff, thank you. Oh my gosh, Jeff, I hated you last night. I have to say thank you to all of you. I mean, last night I had like almost 47,000 people. You have no idea how flattered I am. I love you. I hope that you know that this is a place where we respect each other and nothing, you know, no crude remarks, please, nothing rude, because I'm here for you. And yeah. Always lucky. Hi, how are you, love? Danny, how are you? Danny, how are you, honey? So I got my hair pulled back because this, I have a griddle here that is, here, I'll push it back. Here's the whole deal. I don't know if you can see, but I have a griddle here that is very hot because I'm gonna cook. Got shrimp in the fridge. And yeah, so thank you for being here with me. This is what I do every Friday and Saturday night. I'm at home, like working, either doing content or now I'm going live with you because I love it here. Hot grill, yes. Darren, hi, honey. Thank you for moderating. Thank you so much, Jeff. What the hell is going on here? That is cracks me up. I don't know, can you tell me what the hell is going on here? If you could tell me, that would be awesome. This is just TikTok, yes, and I am Sexy Chef Wendy. If you follow me, you know who I am. If you don't, please come follow me. I am the chef who cooks in lingerie. Yes. So my whole brand, Sexy Chef Wendy, is all about promoting love and romance and sparking flames in relationships through cooking. So that's my whole deal. I dress like this for my brand, and I am a chef. I am a former model. So I created this brand called Sexy Chef because I've been cooking my whole life, and I just thought it'd be fun to create a brand that promotes love and romance through cooking. So I also have products that you probably have seen me hold. My Sexy Chef hot sauce. It's a fermented habanero mash with key lime. It's a carrot base and a little bit of salt and a little bit of garlic. What does a chef look like? I'm always curious when people tell me you don't look like a chef. I'm like, I gotta tell you something. Me personally, thank you. Hi. I'll pull up so I can talk to you for a bit before I start cooking. This is really hot, so I'm just sit up away. Yeah, so when people tell me that I don't look like a chef or whatever they say, I don't understand that. I didn't know that a chef had to look a certain way, but I would want to eat from a chef that looks healthy and fit personally. So I just can say that my food is very holistic, healthy food. I grew up in a house where we grew everything, fruit, vegetables, herbs, everything we picked from our garden. So it's a definitely a healthy way of living. Oh, thanks. Well, thank you so much. I try. You know, it's mind, body, spirit, right? So that's another part of my message. It's all about taking care of yourself. It doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter how young you are. Fortunately, I grew up in a household where I was taught early on to eat healthy. My father was very, he played racquetball every day. So when I was a little girl, I'd go to the gym with him because I thought the guys were so cute, and I ended up working out. I also danced. I dance now too. I take burlesque and jazz classes. I work out. All good stuff. So I have moderators. So if you want to be here, I'm really excited to have you. If you want to be rude, you will be blocked. And what I mean rude is just, you know, you don't have to be insulting or ask me to do anything ridiculous. Hi, Michelle, how are you? So I'm gonna chat for a bit before I start cooking this grill. So I just have a little burner here because my stove's behind me. In my commercial kitchen, of course, I had a Wolf, like, you know, 8-burner gas stove, but I'm in my house that actually where I live, there is no gas here. From Eureka, California. All right, awesome. Thanks for following me. So yeah, this burner, that way it's easier. I can face you, and I have a cast iron griddle that I'm just gonna throw the shrimp on. I'm gonna make something really quick. Thanks, thank you, Mark. Thank you. Thanks for joining me. I'm Sexy Chef Wendy. If you follow me, thank you so much. If you don't, please do follow me. I'm now coming on live pretty much every day. And my whole message, my whole deal as Sexy Chef is to promote love and romance and relationships through cooking. And I also promote a holistic, healthy lifestyle, clean living, mind, body, spirit. That is, you know, everything. You need to be complete in every area. Eat well, think well, you know, be fit, be healthy. We are what we eat. We are what we think. Thanks, Trey. Appreciate it. Hi, Ricky. Ooh, that grill is hot, hot, hot. So like when you ask things like, are they real, you're gonna get blocked. I'm just saying nothing ridiculous, because let me just put it to you this way. If you were like at a party and you were trying to, you know, flirt with a girl, or maybe you were interested in her, maybe you're thinking, maybe I'd like to take her out. You're not gonna walk up to her and say, are those real? And you're not gonna say, turn around. And you're just gonna be like really, hopefully, cute and nice. So if, yeah, no chances. You get blocked pretty quickly from my lovely moderators if you say rude things, okay? So that's part of my whole thing with Sexy Chef. So I have my brand, and I actually work with private clients, and I work with couples. I work with women a lot. I teach them how to cook sexy food and how to be appealing for their husbands or boyfriends. Or lovers, whoever it is. And I teach men how to cook as well. And, you know, I think that, hold on. I work out and I like the idea of eating. Yes, me too. My whole life. It's just, it is, hello, Ricky, how are you? Hello, Lee. So, yeah, also that, there was a weird filter on me last night. I didn't love the outfit and thigh highs. Thanks. They're actually like, so there's a company that gives me, they're called lingerie straps. It's called Promees, P-R-O-M-E-E-S. And they're these lingerie straps. And you've seen me in videos, in this kitchen, you've seen me with the hot sauce here. And you see me go, sunlight get hot. So I have 10 ounce and 5 ounce. And it's all in my link tree in my bio. But my whole thing is about living a healthy, holistic life. I have my entire life. So I believe that, you know, when you preach things, you should also be following what you preach. I personally don't take antibiotics. I live a clean life. I don't drink. I use everything to heal myself through food, natural remedies and foods. And I was raised that way. Do you like A1 or Heinz? I don't know. I don't like either one. Hi, Samantha. Thank you, sweetheart. Hearts back to you. Mwah. You're so beautiful. Thank you. Hi, Lee. The Watcher. Thank you. Hello. How are you? So I know last night there was some bizarre filter. It was making my face Shelly. Thumbs down. Well, Shelly, I have moderators, and I think what we'll do for you, Shelly, I'm just gonna do it myself, is block you, love. There you go. Bye. Don't need any negativity here. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Darren. You like the natural stuff. Yes, I do. Thank you, Lee. So I'll tell you a little secret about me. My dad and my grandfather nicknamed me Woo, W-O-O, Woobird. He died when I was 2 years old, so I don't remember him. But my dad calls me the Woobird of happiness. So I just grew up smiling, kind of in my own little dream world. I just naturally love life. I just do. I think it's beautiful. And I think probably because I grew up like growing, natural food around me. I grew up in a garden and I was able to pick, pull carrots out of the ground and pick fruit off the trees. And I don't know, I just was mesmerized by nature always. And then I started modeling when I was 14. And I start cooking when I was younger than that with my mother. So, yes, I'll show you the shoes. Because you asked so nicely. So if people are rude, I don't want to show them. I know. I'm 5'10". There they are. I'm 5'10", so it's really hard to get everything. Usually I have to push my camera so far back that I wouldn't even be able to see anything on the screen. So. They're Manolo Blahniks. You've seen them in my videos. Right now I'm in Arizona. People ask me that all the time. Where am I from? Started here when I was a kid. My family moved to Maui. My parents are there. And some of my other family members are there. And then I moved to Los Angeles. I worked there modeling in New York and Italy and Spain. And now I'm in Arizona. I moved here right before COVID. I had a ghost kitchen called Sexy Chef for 1 year during COVID where I delivered my restaurant, my kitchen delivered food only. And anyway, so I spend half my time, a little more than half my time here, and my other half in Maui with my family. Thanks for following me. Okay, so I also just started a subscription on TikTok. They just offered it to me yesterday, so I'm new at it. But in my subscription, I'm gonna do lives. And inside those lives, I'm gonna let you come on the screen with me and we can talk. And it's just like, you know, what I do with clients, we talk about cooking, we talk about love, how to build your relationship, be stronger, be healthier, and always, 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 I'll tell everybody, a great relationship starts with you. You must make yourself feel happy and whole and complete inside 100%. We hear that all the time, but it is the truth. And before you can, you know, be involved with anybody else, you need to feel 100% wonderful about yourself. Because nobody can fix us, no one. Except if you believe in God, or I believe in a higher source. That's the other part about me. When I work with clients, I talk about spirituality because I spend a majority of my time meditating and stretching myself in that area. James, you're so cute. Let's talk about you and me. Thank you. That's sweet. You guys are nice tonight. The ones that are rude, my wonderful, awesome Outlaw Farm, Jeff. He is amazing. He will block you if you're rude. Thank you for saying that, Todd. I appreciate it. Hence the Buddha. Yes, did you see it? Can you see my Buddha? Buddhism is the pursuit of happiness. And you know what? How amazing is that? How wonderful is that? Big Greg, thank you for the rose, love. So they're not thigh highs. they are. They're called Promis lingerie straps. It's a company in Europe that has a subsidiary and subsidiary in the United States. So they're lingerie straps, and you've seen them in videos. I thought they're so cute, because if I were to ever have another restaurant, I would want my girls to carry around the hot sauce. And the straps. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Thank you. So as you see, my moderators are blocking anyone who is rude. No rude. Woohoo. I just want to have, girls just want to have fun, right? No, they're not for holding up stockings. So they're kind of like an accessory. And they make them also for like your bra and stuff, but they're kind of like garter belts, but they're just an accessory. Aren't they cute? They're easier than garter belts. They're like a modern version of garter belts. You don't attach hose to it. So if you're to wear hose with it, you would have to wear thigh highs. I'm not going out tonight. So thank you, Big Greg. I'm not going out tonight. I just, I film content all day for my brand. And let me get some water. And I do cameos. I'm gonna get some water. Hi. I do cameos, which are, they're a shout out. So like, you can book your favorite celebrity, or me, or celebrity chef, or actor, or whoever you like on Cameo, and you can book them to do like a birthday greeting or a hello or a... Lately I've had this fitness coach who's been buying them from me to send in his, the guys that are in training, and I've been sending them videos like wishing them luck and, you know, that kind of fun stuff. So I'm always like, I dress up for those. Yeah, and for my videos. Hi, Daryl, thanks for following me. Hi, Lindsay. Big Greg. So yeah, I was a few nights ago when I was on TikTok, I was showing everybody these. So I ask every night, what in the heck are these, people? I'm gonna back it up. What are these? Does anyone know? I may have said it earlier in some of my videos, so Thank you, Tim. Yes, Bobby. Yes, Big Rob. They're not tomatoes, love, but they are persimmons. Yes. Kisses to you, VIP. You're so sweet. Hi, John from New Jersey. Cooper's mom. Junior Dalton. Hi, how are you? Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me. I have a moderator, Outlaw Farm. Please follow him. Darren as well. These are gentlemen that have been following me for years, and they're exactly how a gentleman should be. Gentlemen, right? So these are persimmons, and they're not in season all the time. I knew when my mom's in Hawaii, and she called me and she's like, persimmons are back. So she went and got so many persimmons. I am single. By choice. There's a bug flying in the air. Okay, so persimmons. They're only in season part of the year, and they're in season right now. And pretty much you can get them. Thank you, VIP, that's really sweet. Love you too. Thank you very much. So persimmons are kind of like, they feel tough, sort of like an apple, a little bit squishier than an apple. So when they're really tough, did I move my knife? Oh my gosh, of course I did. Okay. Oh, there it is. I'll just use the big knife. So they're really they're really good. They're so good. Thank you, Alex. Thank you. Oh, Al, thank you, sweetheart. Yes, it's a fruit. So persimmon is a fruit. And look, so I chopped some up earlier because I'm gonna make a salsa. So I chopped them, that's what it looks like inside. So they're kind of small. And basically, they are kind of like the kindest, they're sweet. They're not like sickeningly sweet, but look how amazing. Gosh, that is the way I love food. That's why I think food is sexy. Because natural whole foods are sexy. I mean, look what Mother Nature produced. You could just slice them up and, you know, eat them this way. You can put them on a charcuterie platter. They're so gorgeous. I put them on. They look like little starfish. But I was thinking the other night when I was on TikTok that I'll just do it right now. I did a video earlier behind the scenes. This takes me a long time to set all this up. But I thought it'd be fun to do like a persimmon salsa. So I don't know if anyone likes fruity salsas, but you know, like I make mango or papaya salsa, and I have never made a persimmon salsa, and I just thought, let's do it, let's go for it. I'm gonna find those tomorrow. Yes, go to, so if you're, I don't know where you live, but they definitely have them at Trader Joe's. And they look like an orange inside, but they're not. They're like a mix between, I would say they're like a mix between an apple and a pear, you know? So they're kind of tough, but you know, it's like an apple, you can't really move like that. So when you buy them, you want them to, when you grab them, they feel really like rock solid hard, give them a couple days to get ripe. But when they get a little bit softer, then you can, you know, you can just eat them, you eat them like you would a apple if you want. But They're just so beautiful. I think make sure when you cut them that way. So you can see that beautiful star, because you can just make like little wedges, and it's really pretty. So what I did, you can't really see because I need like a couple of cameras here. But what I did is I just chopped it up like that. Okay, so you just cut it and just chop it in little cubes. Voila. Okay, let me see what everyone's saying. Where I live, they are falling off the trees on the side. Are you serious? Where do you live? I'm very jealous. So like I grew up in a house where we had fig trees, the same thing, like so many figs that we couldn't keep up with them. I literally was like hanging over my mom's diving board. I would pick them and I'd pick them off the tree and eat a bunch of figs and then jump in the pool. That's wonderful. Yeah, we don't have persimmon trees here, but that I know of. I'm sure somebody does, but you know, right now 'tis the season, and they're just like really beautiful. Actually, you know, you can even put them in and Thanksgiving, they'd be delicious in stuffing. Cause like I put apples in my stuffing, or I'll put cran raisins in my stuffing. These would be just as good. Oh, you're in California? Of course you are, yes. So I lived in Los Angeles most of my life. I moved here, back here, right before COVID. Everyone, something show, yes. Hi, Dat Fly Drummer, yes. Thank you, I've got my men here with me. I love you all, thank you. Kane, thank you. Jeff, thank you, Darren. A persimmon is sweet, so it's like, I mean, you can't taste it, but yeah, it's sweet. It's like not as sweet as a raisin, a little bit sweeter than an apple. It has its own unique taste, but yeah, it's delightful. They really are. They're delicious. So good. So I chopped up, that's just like two persimmons, okay? So they're about this size, and you just chop them like in little cubes, right? Little pieces like that. And again, I've never made a persimmon salsa, but I thought it'd be super fun. So I think maybe, you know what? I'll put some lime juice in it. All right, so I got these beautiful limes. Just cut it in half. Do that. Let's add some lime juice. So squeeze some lime juice in it. I'm just going to do one lime. You've seen me do videos like this in slow motion, but now it's in real life, live on TikTok, Sexy Chef, making persimmon salsa for the first time with you guys, because I just made it up the other day. If not ripe, it'll pucker you really bad. Really? Is it sour? Probably, right? Okay, so I mean, honestly, like I use limes on everything, so I just put one lime in there. Limes make everything taste magnificent. Limes are sexy. Food is sexy. Okay, so moving right along. You don't have to add fish sauce, but fish sauce has a nice like little salty taste to it. And I just get this Thai kitchen one. I'm probably just gonna shake it a few times. So if I were to measure that, that's probably like a half a teaspoon. The thing is, you know what? Always go a little bit less, because guess what? As you know, you can always add, you can never subtract. Just like, you know, I very, very rarely, almost never put salt in my food. So when I make guacamole, which I might make tonight, I might add a little sea salt, but limes and lemons kind of add that salty flavor. And then I just put a little bit of fish sauce. Word, yes. So Because you're being so nice, no one's being rude. I'm Sexy Chef Wendy. I'm here tonight. I'm making this persimmon salsa for the first time ever. I've never made persimmon salsa. I have made mango and papaya salsa, and what I use those two salsas for are, when I used to eat red meat, I don't, right now I'm not eating it, but it's great with like a barbecued ribeye steak, delicious, or fish. Fish tacos is what we're gonna do. All right, so what did I do? Fish sauce, yes, okay. And then, oh yeah, I'm gonna add some brown sugar. So I got a little trick for you. Be right back. I'm here. I didn't leave you, I promise. So my brown sugar, never throw brown sugar out. A lot of people will toss brown sugar when it gets hard because they think it's not good anymore. But if you add bread, slice of bread, this brown sugar was rock hard like an hour ago. If you put fresh bread inside a container with your brown sugar, guess what? It's completely soft now. I couldn't do that an hour ago. So you don't have to throw away your brown sugar if it gets impacted and tough and hard. Just put any piece of bread in there. It's the yeast that makes it soften up. So I'm just gonna do you don't need a lot because this is pretty sweet, but it's just another little dimension. I just put like a half a teaspoon. Again, you don't have to. The persimmons already have like a nice little sweetness to it, but brown sugar makes the world go round. Brown sugar is my secret ingredient to everything. And then I'm just gonna chopped up some cilantro earlier. So you know cilantro. And there are some people that absolutely hate cilantro, but it's such a classic flavor for a salsa. Let me see what you're saying. Oh. That was special. Yes, you can have salsa with nachos. You can have salsa with anything. Tomorrow night, I'm gonna cook some swordfish. I'll have it with that. So I'm just gonna, I'm gonna put some fresh cilantro that I just chopped up in there. Mm-hmm. Okay, so got a little bit of fish sauce. Yum. Brown sugar, fish sauce, lime juice, persimmons, and cilantro. Yummy, yummy, yum. Looks so good, so beautiful. And then I'm gonna add a little bit of kick to it, some heat. I was gonna put sesame oil. Hold on, let me see if I can find it. Ooh, I just put some of the hot sauce in my mouth. My hot sauce is hot. Okay, so sesame oil, the reason why I like to use it, it gives it that kind of, it's a little bit of a, kind of a Asian infused flavor, but I love that. I love it. It's kind of like warm. It just gives it a nice, it just blends all the flavors together. And I don't know, warm is the only way I know how to describe it. So we have sweet, salty, warm, and then now spice. So I've got my Sexy Chef carrot based habanero mash salsa. So I'm not seeing any of the rude comments because my moderators are just blocking them, okay? No need to be rude. Okay, so now thank you for the roses, Marco. I appreciate it very much. Thank you, love. I'll stop for a minute and say hello. Thanks for the hearts. I appreciate those of you that are amazing. Thanks, Beach Bum. And I'm listening to, you love my apron. You're so cute. Yeah, Danny, it's ministry radio on Pandora. So it's just like Tool and, I know, it's all my favorite bands. Tool right now, as we know. Love it. If you follow me, you know I'm really into that kind of music, like industrial metal music. I love it. I love it. I love it. Marco, hi from TikToker from Philadelphia. Hi, Marco. Right now I'm in Arizona. My family's from, well, basically here in Maui. I spent half my year in Maui, but I lived in Los Angeles most of my life. I've been everywhere. Okay, so now we're gonna add some of my hot sauce, which is a habanero mash, fermented habanero mash, carrot base. Hi from Oregon, nice to meet you, Virginia Beach. Oh, I hear that's beautiful. So my hot sauce, and Jeff, you'll know when you get it, my new favorite cooking show. Thank you, love. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's so much fun when everybody's nice. I just puts me in a good mood. It makes me want to. It makes me not mind standing up and showing, because you all see my videos. I am Sexy Chef Wendy. You've seen me with my hot sauce. Chromise lingerie straps. They gift me these lingerie straps for obvious reasons. I am Sexy Chef, and I am. They're beautiful. They're a beautiful gift for your wife or your girlfriend, or, you know, if you're into cross-dressing, whatever. They're really awesome. They are not garter belts. They're lingerie straps. They're super cool. Anyway, so now I'm gonna add my hot sauce. So, you know, I like it spicy, okay? I like it spicy, and my hot sauce has got a kick to it, but since it's a carrot base, and a fermented habanero mash, which is like a 2-week process. It's got key lime and salt and garlic in it. You can really taste it. It's quite delicious, if I do say so myself. Hot, yes, yes. Thank you for the roses. Thank you, Bert. Hi, how are you? Thank you for following me. Thank you. And thank you to my moderators. I love you very much. Thank you. Aw, thank you, Trey. So yeah, I'm listening to ministry radio on Pandora. Almost every time you see me make a video, I'm listening to that, except 10 times louder. Thank you, Jeff. Thank you. Oh, I love you too. You know I do. You're amazing. Oh, thanks, TikToker. I'm glad I make you smile. That, when I hear that, I have to tell you, that makes my day. Thank you, Alex. It's really that simple. I started TikTok during COVID. Everyone had told me to get on it. And I was like, oh, I can't do another social media platform. And it's ended up being like my favorite. I love it. And I just went on with the only intention was just to make people happy, because we're in such hard times. COVID was so hard. And I know people are going through a lot right now. I know they are. And a lot of people are lonely, and a lot of people are nervous. But guess what? I'm here for you. I love you. I am Sexy Chef Wendy. I'm always here for you. I hope that I make you smile. That is my intention. And along the way, I hope to teach you how to eat well. Because you know what? If you eat well, you feel good. And that's just the bottom line. You wear pantyhose? Awesome. You know what? You would love these. Then you should get these. They're... Promise is Promees. Got my. They're not garter belts. They're just like, they're badass is what they are. And so I do like this burlesque dance. I'm with a very famous burlesque dance teacher. This is the kind of stuff it's fun to wear, you know, because it's like classy, sexy. I think it is, at least. Okay, so I have made, the persimmon, let's do a recap, okay? Persimmon, somebody from Ventura or Ventura County, California, these are falling off the trees right now. If you see these, eat them, grab them, get them. They're not that expensive in the store though. They're really very inexpensive. They just have bushels of them at Trader Joe's, so I know for sure they have it. So I just made a salsa. And I don't know, like, no, I'm not gonna add avocado because I'm gonna make a little tiny bit of guacamole too. So I'll just show you how beautiful this is. And so besides like for me, besides food like being fresh and tasting amazing, the visual part of food makes it sexy, you know? Like, seriously. So then I have like some cilantro, just put it on the side to kind of make it look prettier. It's so vibrant, and with the holidays coming up right now, so like this salsa, the ingredients all probably cost me like $1.50. Seriously, it's so cheap. Look at that. So you just, you know, like say you're cooking with someone or you have like a date over, or you want to cook with your loved one. And not say neither one of you have ever had a persimmon. You could say, hey babe, hey love, let's go get this persimmon, or look what I found. And experiment, have fun. There are no rules when it's cooked, when you cook. You know, that's the one thing I've learned as a chef. Like, literally, you can't get caught up in like what people, you know, perceive things should be. It's okay to experiment. That's why we're here, right? We're all artists at heart, every one of us. And that's what cooking is. It's just another form of art. Hi. Hi, Dwayne. Good evening. How are you? Thank you for following me. Thank you for following my live. I appreciate it. I appreciate you all. I have three moderators tonight, so no hanky-panky, no funky business, no rudeness. It's more fun when you're not rude. You get a lot more out of me. I'm in a much better mood. I'm happier. I don't mind showing you my lingerie straps. I don't mind showing you my sexy shoes when it's a fun, nice room, not being demanding and mean. Okay, so we have our salsa, right? I gotta move some things here because I got a lot going on here right now. So persimmon salsa. Persimmons chopped up, cilantro, fish sauce, optional. Fish sauce is salty. You've had it a million times in Thai food. You just don't know it. They use it all the time. It's a really great staple to have in your kitchen. Sesame oil as well. Sesame oil kind of takes all the, I put fresh limes in it and a little bit of brown sugar and hot sauce. So the sesame oil just kind of, you know, it just brings it all together. It just makes it smooth and warm. So we have a lot of different layering of flavors going on in here, and that's what's really fun about cooking. You kind of want to hit everything: sweet, salty, spicy. Yeah. You like to cook, Dwayne? Awesome. Thank you, Nassar. I appreciate that love. Yes, Jeff, I can't wait. You have other things in there too. Thank you, Dat, Fly, Drummer, Kane. Thank you, love. Oh, thank you, Dr. Victor. That is the sweetest thing. I appreciate it. Thank you, TikToker. Thanks, Lewis. Thank you, Dr. Victor. Thank you, Lewis. Mark. Max Food Group, nice to see you. Okay, so again, persimmon salsa, that is, I guarantee you, you show up at a holiday party with persimmon salsa, everyone will be like, that's cool. I mean, what made you think of that? You know, so persimmon, papaya, mango, but right now, persimmons are in season, and I say just grab them, cut them up, use them in a charcuterie or a fruit and cheese platter. So I'm gonna bring this back in a minute, okay? Well, I'll just move it over. I'm still here, I'm not leaving. I'm staying here for a while. Ah! Such a small space, but okay. All right, so I'm gonna show you a really quick, easy trick, okay? Let me see what's going on here first. Thank you, TikToker. That's a huge compliment to say I'm a soulful girl. because I would rather be like soulful and nice and sweet than anything else. I think that's the most important thing. Hi, you're from Georgia, Dwayne. I'm in Arizona right now, Phoenix, Arizona. Thank you, user 3992. Thank you. I'm not a gynecologist. Okay. You know, you're going to get blocked, okay? I'm not a gynecologist. Too bad. Sorry. Nothing rude. Don't be crude. So, oh, thank you, TikToker. That's sweet. Thank you for complimenting my lips. Right now, I'm in Arizona. Bruce Lee, great name.
I mean, who doesn't love Bruce Lee, right? Anyway, so yeah, don't say anything rude. So just think of it like this. Hey, I'm at a party and I see a really beautiful girl or guy that I want to get to know. I'm not going to walk up to them and say, hey, you know, spread it, or hey, get up and turn around. You're not going to talk like that. If you do, you'll never have a date. You will never get anyone. Women hate that, by the way. They don't like it when men act like that. I'm just telling you. I'm sure like men, I don't, you know, would prefer a woman to be a little bit classier too when they approach them. So just like, you know, if you're ever wondering maybe why you're having a hard time getting a date, if you're speaking to women like that, it's not like a hard to figure out. Right, Andre? Thank you. I mean, what the heck? Hi from Phoenix, Mark. How are you? Nice to see you. I mean, The Cure, right? This music. So that's the other thing. Like, not only do I teach people to cook sexy food and to live a healthy life. Hi, nice to meet you. Are you new in town? Kind of. I bounce around a lot. I wish I had a beautiful woman. Well, be a beautiful person and you'll find a beautiful woman. You should also give advice on how to approach gorgeous women like yourself. Hey, from Philadelphia. So, okay, that's a really good one. And thank you for saying I'm gorgeous. I appreciate that. You know what? I was married. I've been divorced for a long time. But someone asked me why I was divorced. And I said, well, if you've ever seen the movie Wolf of Wall Street, that's basically my story. I'm not going to say anything bad, but we had several kids. But my husband was very confident. And he saw me go, my ex-husband, he saw me walk into a wedding party. He saw me being photographed. I was in a wedding party. And he literally, he was from New York. And I actually lived in Los Angeles, and I was in Arizona in a wedding. This was like a long time ago, long, long time ago. And he saw me being photographed. And he was this resort. He stood outside with his friend. He stood outside and waited for me to walk out. He made it so I had to like practically bump into him so we could talk. Thank you, Christopher. Thank you so much. Hi, Jack. Hi, Elliot. Hi, Rick Breton. Hi, Chris. Thanks for joining. Hi, Naomi. Hi, Alessio, Alicia. Yeah, so he was, I think the thing is, like you say, like a lot of people are afraid, so afraid to approach maybe someone, a woman that they think is beautiful. They're so afraid to approach them that a lot of beautiful women stay home alone because no one talks to them. It's true. And they feel very like isolated. So anyway, he was really smart. That was a very smart guy, Wall Street guy, Wolf of Wall Street, basically, though. Unfortunately for me, I was very young. He was older than me, but he was smart. And he got my My girlfriend that was with me, she invited him into the wedding. She was married. I was really annoyed with her. Because to be honest with you, I'm super shy, like very, very shy when I'm out in public. That's straight truth. Beautiful, thank you. Yeah, so beautiful women, let's just say like aesthetically, because there's so many beautiful men and women that, I mean, that's a subject, it's a subjective word, because it's like, what is beautiful? I don't know, you know, someone could look great and be a total asshole. You know, they could be like the worst human being. And I know, because I was in the modeling industry and I was around very, very beautiful women that I thought were much more beautiful than me, and guys, and not everybody was, I didn't think they were all necessarily beautiful. Did my ex remarry? No, he did not. He did not. And I've been divorced a long time. We had children together though that I ended up raising. Thank you, PEJ. Okay, thank you for those beautiful flowers. Thank you. Yeah, so I think what I liked about him is he was confident, and he also didn't talk too much. You know, he didn't try to be like his friend that was with him was flirting with me, and his friend was literally promising me the world. Like, he literally was like, I don't know, like, what aren't you gonna give me? And my husband, the one I ended up marrying, just said, can I get your number? I'd like to take you to dinner. I was like, oh my gosh, that was so refreshing. That actually, you know, you're not just trying to like buy me or promise me things. He just wanted to take me to dinner. It's that simple, guys. It's not that complicated. You know, and sometimes when people don't want to go to dinner with you, it's not necessarily because they're not into it. They might just not be in that space of their life, you know? So don't ever take nothing personally, ever. Just be like cool with yourself. I think the more confident you are with yourself, that is super attractive. And you know, my husband and I, he met me, he proposed to me. We were married like 3 months later. And I moved to New York, and we had children together. Put on glasses, okay. Okay, so that way I can see you, or I don't know, if you like my glasses better. Oh, he got blocked, okay. See, a good thing I didn't see what he said. I prefer it. Hi, G, thank you for the roses. Thank you, Trey. Thank you, G, for the rose. That's really sweet. I appreciate it so much. All right, so I made salsa. So right now, I read this article that we actually have, there's too many avocados. There are avocados. So the price for avocados is probably dropping. Because there's such an abundance of avocados. Thank you, Ron. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. So for those of you that aren't being kicked off, because you're not being kicked off because you're nice, here I am. I'm Sexy Chef Wendy. This is me. You've seen me in this kitchen do lots of videos. You've seen me with my hot sauce. You see me holding my hot sauce? That's what it is. It's my Sexy Chef Habanero Mash Carrot Base Key Lime Hot Sauce. And it is hot, hot, hot. Hi, hi, hi. Joshua, hi, how are you? Okay, so avocados right now. Like, when are they ever inexpensive, right? I know amor is love, so that's nice. Lucky Bruno, hello. Okay, so we made the salsa. If you weren't here earlier, you'll see it, but we made persimmon salsa because it's all about sexy. Sexy food, sexy life, happy life. Eat well, be happy, be sexy, feel good about yourself. Feel good about yourself because you eat well and you choose to be happy and you choose to be a good person. Thank you, Ron. Thank you for saying that, sweetheart. Thank you.
Eric, you're gonna have to go, love. I'm sorry, you can't say things like that. You're gonna get blocked, babe.
That's the other thing. You wanna know how to get a gorgeous woman? Don't be tacky, don't be rude. Or any woman for that matter. I mean, seriously, like, women don't wanna hear that stuff. They don't wanna have you send photographs. You know what I'm talking about, the guys that do that. Don't send private part photographs. Like, that's like the most awful thing you could do. Thank you, Darren.
Okay, so my oldest is 25, my daughter, my middle one is 23, my son, and then I have an 18-year-old daughter, and I have a stepdaughter that I raised as well, that all the same dad, she's older. So I got married really young. My husband was older. I was really naive. I'm happy I married him. He was smart, Wall Street guy, but he was definitely the wolf of Wall Street. 100%. When I saw that movie, I kind of cried because I was like, that's my life. Totally my life. So avocados right now are in abundance. So you may notice everything else in the supermarket. This one, I don't think it's right. No. Thought it was right. I was hoping it would be right. I knew we were like maybe a day away. So yeah, I'm not going to... Well, I could try. See, that shouldn't happen. If it was ripe, it would just like, this is like a day away. And the way you can tell, like when you hold an avocado, hold on a sec. Don't leave me, I'll be right back. So I have all these avocados right now. This one actually might be ripe. Yeah, I think this one is. So you see how it's a little bit darker, this one?
It's like, you gotta feel them. You gotta pick them up. If you want an avocado that night. And it has to like indent just a little. If it doesn't have any flex to it at all, it's not ready.
Hey, sweetheart, I have to run. I love you. I love you. Okay, love you too, Jeff. Thank you so much. Thank you. Mwah. I'm not in California, do Elvis show in Philly. Cool, that's super cool. So when you say give a turn, you get blocked. Darren, you can block him, please. Or Kane, thank you. Thank you, Jeff. Jeff, you had to do that one last before you left. Or thank you so much.
So yeah, I get bummed when I cut an avocado and it's not right, but I think this one is. Yeah, that one feels a little better. There, that was right. So you see the difference? If you were here watching me, see how it, when I cut it, this one isn't quite right. So the avocado stuck to the seed. I'll still eat it. I'll still eat that avocado. But right now they're in abundance. There's so many avocados, so they're cheaper. So I just score it like this, horizontally, both ways, okay? And I just kind of like mush it a little, and I take a fork, and see, it just comes out in little cubes like that. That way I never use a chopping board, and I just get it right out like that. So it's super easy. Definitely when I cook and I just took that seed right out. So watch again, okay? You just score it both ways. You do look. Horizontal lines down and then opposite. And you wanna go all the way so you can feel the skin, the bottom. And then I just take a fork and scoop it right out. Never had to use a chopping board. Less of a mess unless you drop it in your hands like I just did. So the reason why, so I have the persimmon salsa, which I just put my glasses in by accident. And I'm just
Are you married, sweetie? I am not. Check out my Elvis shows in Philly. I well love. I live in Arizona. And half the time in Arizona, half the time in Maui.
Okay, so the avocado. So I'm gonna do that because I'm gonna quickly cook up some shrimp. So I told you I was gonna cook live tonight. So kind of like, a little bit like what we did. I'm gonna get a lemon. Okay, so I cut up, that's just one avocado. Facebook girl, do you know me on Facebook? Do we know each other on Facebook? Hi, Mike. Thanks for the hearts, love. All right, so I'm gonna cut this lemon in half. Darren, if he said something weird, just get rid of him, babe, it's fine. Not into weird. Okay, so lemon. I just chopped it in half. Lemons are sexy too. I use lemons on everything, literally everything. Okay, so just squeeze an entire lemon. There's one avocado, okay? A lemon or lime? Well, honestly, it doesn't matter. It's a preference. Some people, like when they make guacamole, they only use limes. I kind of like, when I do like my guac, I just like the taste of it better. It honestly doesn't matter. Philadelphia, love you too, thank you. So, yeah, I just put a lemon in there, and like someone asked me what's the difference between a lemon and lime. I mean, they're a little bit strong. It's a different taste. It's a little bit more tart. They're both tart, but limes are delicious, like on seafood. I prefer it on seafood. It's a very subtle difference, but it doesn't really matter. So some people like their guacamole in those like cubes like I did, or, stand for a minute. Hello, you're reset. Hi, I'm Sexy Chef Wendy. I'm in my kitchen. My brand is Sexy Chef Wendy. My whole mission and goal and statement in life is to rekindle and re-spark and bring flames back into relationships through cooking. And I have several products. One of them is my habanero mash hot sauce, which I'm going to put into the guacamole right now. So this is one because I'm gonna make tostadas for two. So this is literally just one avocado. You don't have to overdo it. I've used like two persimmons. And then I'm just gonna put some hot sauce in it. The hot sauce, my hot sauce is hot. It's got kick to it, but I love it. And again, with anything, kind of just add a little bit at a time because you can always add more. You can never take away. Ben, hello, how are you? I'm in heels, love. Heels, yes. Hi Jack, how are you? Happy Saturday night. Okay, so I added hot sauce. I have habanero hot sauce to that. It's looking kind of gross. All right, and then I'm just gonna put a little bit of, now again, there's some people that just despise cilantro. So I guess that's something you'd wanna know beforehand, but I'm just gonna chop up a couple sprigs of cilantro and toss it in. Oh, let's see what you're saying. Thank you for saying my hair is nice. I have it pulled back tonight, so it's not like in the food, because that would not be very attractive. And then I have a little bit of sea salt. I don't use salt much, I told you, but I do put it in my guacamole, just a little bit. You just saw it. That's just a tiny bit. You don't even have to put it in, but I don't know, tastes good. Just get natural sea salt or Himalayan sea salt. Cilantro pulls metals out of the body. So true. Absolutely. That's, so does chlorella. Chlorella is really great for pulling metals out of your body. It's something I drink every day. I drink, like, I actually put, they're chlorella pills, and I take them every day with my greens and celery juice and ginger, all good stuff. Okay, so I have moderators, so I don't know if you say bizarre things, we're just like not into it. I am super happy to have you here tonight, and I'm happy to answer questions and be playful and fun, but nothing rude, nothing crude. If you have any questions that are appropriate, I would love to answer them. Okay, so that is literally how I make my guacamole, guys, and you watch me do it in 2 seconds. You can use a lemon or a lime, and I just did avocado, lemon, salt, and cilantro, and hot sauce. Okay, so far we've got, so good, so good. We have our persimmon salsa, guacamole, and I've been talking a lot, but it did not take me that long to do that. So it's more like when you're cooking with someone, it's not really like, oh, how long is it gonna take? Because who cares? You know, you're there to have fun with whoever you're cooking with. The reason why I introduce different fruits to people is because I think it's playful and more fun when you're cooking with someone to have like something that's not common. Like, for instance, later this week, I'm gonna be talking about dragon fruit. And this is like one of the best antioxidants you can have. This is a golden dragon fruit and a pink dragon fruit. Very common, very typical in Maui. This is our go-to. My mother has bags full of these at her house. Dragon fruit is so good for you. So, yes, so Sexy Chef is not only is it about, you know, bringing love and romance back into relationships through cooking. It's about being sexy through food. Like, food makes you feel great if you're eating the right food. Food can make you feel like crap if you're eating the wrong food. If you're eating processed foods or foods that have colors and dyes and hormones in them, they can really affect your mood and your libido and the way you think, your mindset. So part of also what I do is I bring a conscious awareness to people about food. So you've seen me here tonight live just make very simple persimmon salsas, all fresh ingredients. I mean, okay, we added a little fish sauce, but you don't have to do that. And then a very quick guacamole, nothing crazy, but just really fresh and wholesome and delicious. So, you know, when you're cooking with your sexy partner or you're wanting to have fun with them, you know, think about what you're cooking. You want to make sure the food is like healthy and energetic and making you feel good so you can have fun. Hi from Texas. I love Texas. Texas party tonight, yeah. So, you know what my new favorite place in Texas is? I love Austin. Austin is badass. Okay, so open gets blocked. Darren or Kane, you could block him. Happy Thanksgiving, love. Oh, MBS, that's so cute. Thank you. I love dogs. Chicken chick, LOL. I like your kitchen. Te gusta la cocina. Gracias. Muchas gracias. Okay, so are you guys ready? Are you ready to cook shrimp? All right, I defrosted some shrimp today. Isn't that beautiful? That is beautiful shrimp. So I'm gonna just do like a shrimp tostada, but we already have pretty much done. Because I've got the tostadas in the background. I was getting tacos, but I bought these organic. I didn't buy the ones I normally buy. And they, when I brought them home, they were all completely falling apart, so I could not make the tacos. Good morning. Is everything okay? Yes. Why, everything is wonderful. Almond, hello, how are you? Shrimp, yes, shrimp. And back to Texas. I love Austin. The food is tremendous. The people are fantastic. The architecture there, I love it. I absolutely love it. It reminds me, because I lived in LA most of my life, Los Angeles. It reminds me of Los Angeles when Los Angeles was amazing, like many, many moons ago. Cheers to you too. Thank you. Thank you for loving my outfits. I appreciate it. Okay, so I have this, I don't know if you can see. So I have this, hi Lily, my dogs just came in. You know, my dogs heard me say the word shrimp and they both just literally ran downstairs. Okay, so my oven in my commercial kitchen, my stove, sorry, was a gas. I had a beautiful Wolf Range gas stove oven. Sorry, I'm a little tired. But anyway, where I live in Phoenix, it's strange. This area, there is no gas. It's electric only. Kind of weird. Saludos. So I just have like a hot plate, but I put this cast iron griddle here. And it's very hot. And I'm going to grab... You know, I'm gonna put some lime juice. You know that song, put the lime in the coconut, put the lime in the coconut. Sometimes a lot of times I would add coconut to this, but I don't have coconut right now, which is not my norm. So we're gonna put lime juice, fresh lime juice in the shrimp. I have an Insta, yes. Go to my Instagram, Sexy Chef Wendy Lane. It's in my bio. Yes, put the lime in the coconut and shake it all up. And I wish I could sing so badly. If there was a genie and she came here right now and she said, Wendy, you have one wish, what could I grant? I'd say, I wish I had the most beautiful singing voice. That would be so fun. Okay, but I do love music. All right, so let's put some limes. Lime juice. I always have an abundance of lemon and limes in my house because I put lemons and limes on absolutely everything. Everything. So I eat avocado toast in the morning. I just smash avocado on sourdough toast and I squeeze a lemon or lime. That's like my go-to. So anyway, I just added a fresh lime to the shrimp. So this griddle is, like if you have this on your stove, just get your cast iron griddle. You can clean it with, don't clean it with soap and water. Just clean it with all hot water and olive oil. And then get it really hot. No. You're gonna get kicked off if you tell me to turn or pivot or anything like that, love. We're not doing that. You get so much more out of me when you don't talk like that. Okay, so I'm just gonna make this really simple. I put lime juice. This is soy sauce. I'm gonna put like, here. I never measure, but let's try this. It's a tablespoon right here. So like 2 tablespoons. There's like 12 shrimps in there. So, and it's low sodium soy sauce. All right, and fresh lime. I mean, you could just practically just eat it like that. So good. I have a little bit of tagine here, and I just like to add that another little flavor. So it's basically just, you know, spices, red pepper, and just gonna put a little bit of that in there. And you know, I buy dry spices and I blend them myself. I buy them organic and then I blend them myself. I make curry and all kinds of fun spices myself, so it's super fresh. And once I do that, I refrigerate them because it keeps them fresher. Oh, 74. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of you. Kyle, you're just not nice. Just a jerk. It's like so weird, the things people say. Just to like, I mean, that, you know, if you're gonna insult me, at least like be realistic. I mean, 74, if I was 74, dude, you should like literally be getting notes from me right now. You should say, if you really think I'm 74, my God. Sometimes I wonder, is that, well, I'm not even gonna say. Okay, it doesn't matter because life is good. I'm Sexy Chef Wendy. I'm here to teach you how to cook fresh, healthy food. And I just made that nice little marinade for the shrimp. You could actually make it the night before. But see, the limes are already, look at that, already starting to cook the shrimp. That's how you make ceviche, okay? So the longer, if you make a marinade and you don't want it to cook, add the citrus later, okay? So it's already cooking right now. And honestly, if it just sat there for an hour or two, it would be delicious just like that. And my age is irrelevant. It's not even like, has no bearing. No one's age does. I tell everyone that. I said, we are all timeless creatures, every one of us. So depending on how you take care of yourself, you could be like 32 and look 52, you could be 52 and look like 22, you could be 70 and look like 90, you could be 90 and look like 70. It's how you treat your body. It's how you take care of yourself, it's your attitude. It's how you are mentally, physically, emotionally. It's what you eat. So if you say rude things, you get blocked love. Are you tan? You have nice skin tone. I'm not tan right now. I mean, I'm naturally, my father is German. Looks like you. Thank you, user. Thank you. I feel like I've taken good care of myself. I've tried. My father's German. He has brown skin all year round, whether he goes in the sun or not. So I think I got a little bit of that. Oh my God. Where is your right eye? Why? Oh, there. I have a sleepy eye, lazy eye. No. 70s and 80s babes look better than, yeah, I'm an 80s babe, that's for sure. No, I don't want this boy right here. The young boy, I'm just not into that. So the young boy guy, will you block him, guys? Again, like, just, be nice, be gentlemen, be gentle women. Thank you, love. I don't need my eye fixed. I really don't. sometimes it's because I'm tired too. When I get tired, it becomes more noticeable. How are you and how are you? I love you so much. Thank you. Appreciate that. Sometimes it goes so fast, loves. I can't read it. Hello, how are you? Hi from Idaho. Nice to see you. Okay, so this is hot. So I'm gonna. So the lime juice is already. It's already cooking. Okay, it's cooking the shrimp. Thank you. I'm doing well. Thank you for the flower, the rose. Mana Hari, Manex Hari. Thank you. If you cook for me, I take care of you. I cook for everyone all the time. Yes, thank you. From Boise, Idaho, nice. Yeah, that's why people, I think, sometimes tell me I get Marilyn Monroe locks. My eyes, like, and if it's been a long day and I've got lights in my eyes, but when I'm like on, I open them, trust me. So, okay, I'm gonna throw some shrimp on the barbie. So I just have this, I found this cast iron griddle, guys. I found it at like, I don't know, I think like Ross or something, like one of those discount places. Because they're normally like super expensive. And I've always had like a griddle on my stovetop, but I don't now. So I was like, oh, I need one, and I found this. I found this, and it's great because you can just put it right on the electric top, which I have now because my house does not have gas, which is really annoying because I've never really had to cook on electricity. So it's just different. I mean, I'm not gonna complain. I'm very grateful, but I need a chef. I cook all of my own food. Yes, so yeah, when I do pictures and stuff, I make sure to open my eye. Had it since I was a kid, not a big deal. Okay, so I'm just gonna flip the shrimp. So I did lime juice, soy sauce, tagine. I think that's all I put in it. Again, you can add whatever spice you want, or you can just do nothing. You honestly don't have to put anything on it. But the lime juice already starts to cook it. And you can eat shrimp fully cooked through, or you can have it, you know, of course, if you eat it in a restaurant, all restaurants usually cook it all the way through, unless you're in a Japanese restaurant where you're having a delicacy and you're having raw shrimp. But people are afraid of raw shrimp. I am not. Prime 112, South Beach, Florida. Where is that, a restaurant? Sounds good. Are you good at cooking breakfast? Yes, I am. So I've had a restaurant. I've catered. I ran celebrity catering business in Los Angeles. I've done lots of film shoots and things like that. I can cook anything, but the way that I like to teach people how to cook is fresh, wholesome, healthy, and quick. Because I would rather you, they say, well, cooking takes so long. It really doesn't. If you have fresh ingredients, it doesn't take long at all. Because if I wasn't yakking so much, we would have had this done, this whole meal. We would have had our guacamole and our persimmon salsa and our shrimp, honestly, like 15 minutes maybe, and then we're gonna put it on tostada. Yeah. So I'm gonna turn this off. It's hot. Yeah, so I had promised you all that I would cook live, and I did. So I get asked all the time, how tall are you? I am 5'10". That's tall. When I have my heels on, I'm over 6 feet tall. See, I'm tall. So that's why I have to kind of move my camera back, get close, because I'm tall. My mother is taller than I am, okay? So somebody said they thought I was 74 years old. And I think I should be a millionaire. I think I should sell the secret, right? I don't even take it as an insult. I think it's funny. I think people are funny. Funny. Hysterical. Thank you. Okay, so I was gonna do tacos. I said I'm gonna do tacos tonight, but the tacos, the tortillas that I bought, and I normally get them at the Mexican market down the street, but I didn't have time to go there. I bought them at a health food store and they were organic and they're good, but they completely fell apart. Like, not one of them was whole. So I had these tortillas, little tortillas, so we'll just do that. No big deal, right? So what we're going to do, folks, is we're going to take a, so this is two people. This is dinner for two because we're on date night, right? Okay? So it's one avocado, that's it. Because we're not gonna overeat because we wanna be able to have fun in the rest of the night. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of the guacamole, and I made chunky guacamole because I like it like that. You can make it smoother and smush it if you want, but you're gonna just put that on the tostadas. Can you see? My lazy eye, and what else? It's like, there's this guy, I forget his name, Luke something. I follow him on TikTok. He's like, you know that one person that walks in the room and literally like insults everybody, like never looks at what's nice. They just say, why are you wearing that outfit? Or I don't know, it's just funny. Finding like, there's always a person that finds like fault. I'm gonna get a tissue, I'll be right back. I'm not going far. Okay. So, again, I have these lingerie straps on. They are not garter belts. They're Promise lingerie straps. It's a company that I promote their lingerie straps. They're really sexy. They're fun. You've seen me wear my hot sauce bottle in them. You've seen me do videos in here all the time. You've seen me on the counter. You've seen me holding the bottle. This is where it all happens. This is where the magic happens. Okay, let's see. Yeah, if they're not respectful, babe, just block them. You don't have to tell them. You don't have to tell them. If you're not respectful, you just get blocked. So like turn, the guy that says turn will get blocked because it's not respectful, yes. So not a big deal. No big deal, not at all. All right, so now we've got these shrimps. Now look at them, how perfect. So they kind of cooked a little bit when they were just, you know, in the marinade because of lime juice. Now, see, I'm just gonna open my eye. I'll be like this. So it's not lazy. No lazy eye. Bedroom eyes, I've been told. Okay, so I'm gonna put six on each plate. That honestly, like, you don't need more than that. That's more than enough, trust me on that. So those are just some extras for my dogs. Or later, you know, later if you want, like, to have a little bit of a snack, you'll have some extra shrimp. So now I'm gonna do this. Hi. Hi, TikTok, how are you? Thanks for being here. Thanks for putting up with me. Thanks for hanging out with me tonight on a Saturday night in Sexy Chef. We promote love and romance and relationships through cooking. That is my message. And I promote holistic, healthy lifestyle. Harrison, I love you too. Thank you, love. Thank you, Mark. You are the best. Thank you, sweetheart. Thanks for saying you love my outfit. Okay, so I'll all right, so look, we've got, look at this. Hi, I'm Sexy Chef Wendy. Thanks for joining me. I'm not leaving yet, still here. Just wanted to say hi for those of you that have just popped on. I got a lot going on here, a lot going on here. Okay, so we just made these, all right? That's plenty for two people. It truly is. It's more than enough. And then we're gonna do this. We've got this persimmon salsa. Remember we made that in the beginning? Okay, so we've got this gorgeous persimmon salsa, persimmon, and I'm just gonna put it on top. I'm just gonna roll it right on top. And I like to use tongs. If you're in the industry, you know, you understand. Tongs are our life. Okay, so I'm just gonna throw the salsa on top. And this is like beyond decadent, beyond delicious. It was super easy. This whole meal for two people, this sexy meal, I would venture to say, I mean, I'd have to calculate the numbers, but it probably cost me, the shrimp was the most expensive, so maybe like $20. And I'm gonna put a little cilantro on top. So it's not like, you gotta break the bank to make something sexy and beautiful. And then I'm gonna do this. See this orchid? Orchids. I put flowers on all of my food. If you follow me, you know that. All my plates, all my food has flowers. Good night. Okay, Linda. Sorry, late to this. What are you making? Hi, Ray. Well, I'll probably, I'll probably put it on YouTube so you can watch. So I'm gonna put that. I can't move that yet, but here we go, look. So we made this, look what we made. We made shrimp tostadas with and, you know, isn't that pretty? You can even do this. That's sexy. That is sexy. Shrimp tacos. We put the guacamole on the bottom. Grilled shrimp that we marinated in lime juice, tagine, and soy sauce. That's it. Three things. You don't need to go crazy. Three things. The lime juice immediately starts cooking the shrimp. So you could just let it marinate. We could have had ceviche. We didn't have to cook it if we left it in more lime juice and left it in longer. And then
that delicious, sexy persimmon salsa, which I have never made until tonight. It was my first time. Wow. I'm a persimmon salsa virgin. I haven't even tasted it. I'll cook with you any day, lovely. Thank you. Hey, how are you? My dogs are crying. They're like, Mom, please give me some shrimp. I'm gonna put some on the side for them right now. So I know what I love to cook. What do you love to cook? Hey, how are you? Thank you for the hearts. Thank you for just being overall amazing, everyone. I love my TikTok family. Hi, Vincent. How are you? Great name. Hi, Alan. So I have my hair pulled back tonight because I didn't want to get it in the food. But, you know, if I was ready to sit down my date, I'd get a brush and brush out my hair. And hey. But I don't know. I think it looks better pulled back tonight. Now it's all crazy. I don't know what I did. My dogs have been sitting here patiently while I've been cooking. Here, baby. Well, thank you. I mean, I hope you enjoyed cooking this with me as I promised I would. And, you know, again, my whole thing is like making fresh, whole foods, natural ingredients. You don't need to have like, you know, like 10 different things in a marinade. You can just keep it simple. If you're using like lemons and limes, it's just soy sauce, a coconut, a liquid amino acid is great to have in your pantry as well. Bravo for cuisine. Merci. I'm from Arizona and Maui. Forget the cooking. Why? Oh, thank you. Merci. Merci beaucoup. Hi, Hugo. I can make teriyaki. I can make anything. Hi from Mexico. Besos. Kisses to you too. So the thing about TikTok Live, because I have a light behind me, is the writing is, it's so tiny, it's ridiculous. Like, I gotta figure out, I think other people have either their computer or an iPad so they can expand it. It's very, very impossible to read when I'm trying to cook, and then I have a light behind me, so that's why sometimes I go like that. Because I actually have contacts, I can actually see everything around me perfectly clear, but the writing is so minuscule, that is why. That's why you see content creators like get this close. Thank you. And then I'm super tall. So like for me to stand up, there's no way that you can see my shoes because I'm too tall. That's what I'm wearing tonight. Manolo Blahnik, old school. I'm Sexy Chef. And I promote love and romance and encourage people to have fun and cook together and be sexy in the kitchen together. Make great food. You're from North Carolina, nice. So the shrimp, you know, you can add whatever. Some people like more Cajun spices. I put tagine, which is kind of a milder, you know, it's definitely milder than Cajun spices. I can't boil water? Okay.
That, okay, wait, I gotta find that person. I'm just, I mean, again, fashion, cook, creative, hello. You want to pay them? I don't know where that person, oh, there you go. Let's get rid of you. Lock. Not only can I boil water, but I have a restaurant called Sexy Chef. You can Google it. I handcrafted the menu myself. I love cooking. I think it is the most beautiful act of love is to cook for somebody. It shows that you care about them, that you, you know, that you're thinking about them. I can't cook as good as you, okay? I don't like arrogant chefs, okay? Because I know a lot of very well-known chefs and you know, we learn from each other. I'm very good friends with many celebrity chefs. And nobody knows everything. Every chef has their own skill set. I have my own skill set. I love to learn. I certainly don't know everything. But if I don't know how to cook something, or if I don't know a method, or, you know, I love to learn. I mean, that's just life, right? It's like a musician. A musician, you know, plays one instrument, may not play all instruments, but they like to learn. An artist can create their art across all different mediums. I would say that one of mine is I do really beautiful fruit and cheese and charcuterie platters. All my food is on my Instagram page. I have an Instagram page called Sexy Chef Wendy Lane, which is where I'm in lingerie and I'm cooking. And then I have a Chef Wendy Lane Instagram page where you can see just my food, and you can see what I make. So I definitely have a more of like a South Pacific style to my cooking because my family has been in Maui for almost like 3 decades. So I'm very influenced by that style. That's why you see like orchids, and a lot of the flavors that I use are very South Pacific, and lots of natural healthy foods. Sometimes I don't know what the heck is going on. Okay, there we go. Can you go on IG? I might, yeah. I'll probably go over there in a bit. Kylie, hi, my love. You know what, Kylie? You and I should do a cooking video together. We'd probably give everyone a heart attack. Follow Kylie Fox. She is a friend of mine. She is an absolute babe. And not only is she gorgeous, like beautiful, sexy, she is the sweetest, most darling girl. I love her. Last time I saw her, I was in Maui at the Four Seasons. I think we were eating sushi. I like America. We're more confident. Yeah, I mean, I think so. Yeah, Kylie, it's, I love watching your content. You're gorgeous, you look amazing. Yeah, going live is super fun, but you know, we get some people in here that sometimes are a little bit rude. It's okay though, you know why? Because I'm happy. I'm happy and I love one of the most beautiful hair on the planet. Thank you. If my moderator doesn't take you off, I will. All right, so thank you. I've been on here for a long time. I hope you enjoyed my video tonight. I hope you enjoyed my live. Please leave comments. Please follow me on Sexy Chef Wendy Lane Instagram. I'm on live at least 6 nights a week now. It's a super fun time cooking for you, with you. You're my date tonight. And I just wanted, again, to say thank you so much for all of you that follow me. I love you. I'm Sexy Chef Wendy. My whole mission and goal in life is to bring more love to this world and to spark love and romance in relationships through cooking. I am going to head over to Instagram for a bit. I'm going to show my Instagram family what we prepared together here tonight on TikTok. So if you want to meet me over there, I'll see you there. I love you. And thank you so much to my moderator.